Hello, and welcome to the Open Data Portal, or ODP, video tutorial series. The Open Data Portal combines several data dissemination services into one site to help you easily discover and extract the USPTO data that you need. New, improved features in the site will empower you to get the data that you need more efficiently. Just a reminder that the USPTO is transitioning away from the Patent Examination Data System, or PEDS, and the Bulk Data Storage System, or BDSS. Let's get started. In this video series, we'll cover how to navigate and access different products and pages in the ODP site, how to search, select, view details, and download patents in the patent file wrapper, how to search and download bulk data in Bulk Data Directory, how to use the API page to learn about different endpoints in the API, access API example code, and obtain an API key, and lastly, we'll go over where your API key information is in the site and the ODP's support features. Please note that this recording is using the beta version of the ODP site and closely resembles the version we will launch, but there may be one or two elements that will be slightly different. And with that, let's begin. On the ODP homepage, you can access all the features available. At the top of the page is a site navigation menu. You can use this navigation to jump to specific data products, view API information, or get support, such as frequently asked questions or notes on the latest releases. And this navigation menu will remain at the top of the page regardless of what part of the site you are on. Now, let's explore the Patent File Wrapper. The Patent File Wrapper is a great application where you can view and download patent data filled after January 1st, 2001 to identify critical patent trends and analyze innovation opportunities in key technology spaces. You can access the Patent File Wrapper through the navigation bar under Data Products, or simply click the Explore Patent File Wrapper on the link within the homepage. If you want to download the entire patent data set, we have a banner at the top with a link to both the entire dataset as well as the Delta dataset of the Patent File Wrapper. Below that, and on top of the Patent File Wrapper table, is the search bar. This is where you can plug in certain parameters to find a specific patent. To search using specific parameters, click on How Can I Improve My Search Results under the search bar. To exit the window, click the X at the top right of the window. You can also view the API code of the patent or patents by checking the patents row within the table and selecting the API query button up at the top right. In this window, you can also quickly copy the API code by selecting Copy Query. Within the table itself, we broke up the patent data properties into their own separate columns. These columns are customizable. You can adjust what data you want to see by clicking the Table Columns button. In the Table Columns window, you can select and unselect all data points or pick individual data points that you want the table to display. As more table columns are added, the table scrolls farther and farther to the right. Once you've decided on what table columns you want to see, click Apply Selection to add those columns to the table. To exit the Table Columns window, click the X at the top right of the window. Now, let's explore the patent details. To see the details of a patent, click the name of the patent on its individual row. This will pull up the patent details flyout window. As you can see, it's very similar to the structure of PEDS. Details of the patent, such as continuity information, patent documents, and attorney information, are organized in their own specific tabs on the left. You can also download both the JSON and API information for this particular patent by clicking the Download JSON and API Query buttons. You can jump to the next patent in the table order using the Previous and Next buttons located on the top right of the panel. If you want to expand the flyout panel, just click the Expand arrow at the top right of the panel. Click it again to condense it back to its original form. Click the X at the very top right of the Details flyout panel to exit the panel. And that concludes the basics of the ODP's Patent File Wrapper. Next, we'll move on to the ODP's new bulk data products. You can use the bulk data directory to download large files to update your local patent databases or docketing systems. We split each individual data set into their own card with their own title, description, available dates within the directory, and when the directory was last updated. On this page, you can also search by the title or the data set or directory. For instance, I'll search patent assignment XML. And there it is. You can filter the bulk data sets using the left bar filters as well. In order to view a list of all bulk data files within a particular data set, you click the title. Within the directory, you have a list of all the data files, the date that they were updated, and the size of the individual file. You can also filter between release dates using the filter feature here. We also have certain bulk data directories, such as the patent file wrapper bulk data sets, broken into their entire and delta data sets that you can toggle using the tabs. Each data set file is downloadable by clicking its title. We also offer quick links to related data sets on the right, as well as sample code. As you can see, bulk data is very similar to PEDS, just better organized so that you can easily find what you need. Next, let's explore the API section of ODP. The API section is where you can learn how to obtain an API key and review other features that our API service provides. You can jump between different pages using the navigation on the left. The Getting Started page is your how-to guide on obtaining and using an API key. You are required to have an API key in order to use the API endpoints provided by ODP. If you're more of a visual learner, we have an API syntax example page that has both simple and advanced examples of the USPTO API that you can copy and paste into your own code. Next, we have a list of all the features that the API provides, from how to search using the API, to how to access product data and bulk data sets through the API endpoints. An API endpoint is a URL that acts as the point of contact between an API client and an API server. Each page has information on the API endpoints, different responses you get from the APIs, a list of all the data properties, definitions of those endpoints, and the nested attributes that are in bags that those properties belong to. A bag is a collection of fields for a category or section of the data. And on the right is an example of the JavaScript object notation, or JSON, that the different endpoints provides. Each page contains links back to the API examples, as well as a link to a Swagger page that shows you how to use your API key to extract ODP data. In order to use the ODP API, you are required to have an API key. To obtain an ODP API key, you'll need to go to the MyODP page, log in using your USPTO.gov data, and then verify your account through IDB. Both these steps are required to make sure that your API key is as secure as possible. If you do not have a USPTO.gov account, you can create one using the button below. Next, let's view the page through the eyes of a user who is already logged in and has access to an API key. You can see now that we are logged in as a verified user who has both a USPTO.gov account and has that account verified through IDME, and now we have access to an API key. We also have additional information on your API key within the MyODP page, including the status of your key and the date that the API key was issued. If you want more information on the rate limits of the API key, our FAQ page has those details. Speaking of FAQs, let's explore some of the support features we have in the new ODP site. In our FAQs, you can find answers to common questions, including how to use ODP, what data we offer, and much, much more. We also include information on the ODP API rate limits. In the release notes page, you'll find information about new features and functionality planned for each release. Lastly, the contact page is where you can go to send us any questions or comments. Simply click on the Send Us a Message link, enter your message, and click Send. We also have a newsletter you can sign up using the link at the footer of the site. The newsletter keeps you updated on ODP's progress with the new site and any notes on future updates. And that concludes the video on the new ODP site. We're excited to bring you this new tool for USPTO data. Please stay tuned for more updates. And if you have any questions, email us at support@USPTO.gov.